chatty.
Okay, so I've been waiting, very, very excited to do this haul. And I know you guys have been excited too if you follow me on Instagram. I made 2 orders on urbandecay.com, and I was trying to figure out the best day, the best lighting, the best area, everything for this video because I'm so excited for it. And it will just never be the perfect lighting, the perfect scenery, the perfect anything, just because you guys know my whole world has been shooken up recently, and so this is the best that's gonna, you know, that it's gonna be for right now. And I really, really wanna use these products and add them to my collection and all that stuff. So anyways, first, a little disclaimer. I know I promote cruelty-free beauty and all that stuff, and there is some controversy with Urban Decay because a couple years ago, they were thinking about testing on animals, and that caused a huge controversy with people that purchased Urban Decay because they're cruelty-free. And the response that they got from announcing that news, because the whole reason why they were going to start testing on animals was because they were going to start selling their products in China. And in China at that time, every cosmetic had to be tested on animals for it to be sold in their country. Anyways, they got such an overwhelming response of their customers saying, oh my gosh, we're disappointed in you. Sorry, there's like a whole bunch of noise. The freeway is literally right there, people. So they decided to change their mind, and so they are cruelty-free. I mean, it is kind of upsetting that they would even think about changing their whole policy. But overall, I'm glad that they, you know, decided to stick to being cruelty-free and vegan and all that stuff. Because I honestly have been a fan of Urban Decay. Urban Decay was the first high-end brand that I really fell in love with back in probably like 2010 or something, when I first started getting into high-end makeup. I fell in love with their eyeshadows and all that stuff. Anyways, the whole thing, now I have a professional makeup artist certificate. I went to makeup school last year, and I applied for a whole bunch of different companies. Some companies have programs where you can like send in a whole bunch of proof and information about yourself, showing that you are a certified makeup artist. So you can get up to like 60% off on Urban Decay specifically. If you have, you know, go through the whole process, you get 40% off. Unfortunately, it doesn't apply to every item on Urban Decay. It only applies, like for example, it doesn't apply to palettes, sale items, or I don't know what else, but not everything I got was discounted. Anyways, and I did buy all this with my line of credit, so I do have to pay it off. I'm not a baller, you guys obviously know that. I'm struggling even to just pay to live here. Anyways, let's get into the haul, blah, 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 yeah. So, my first order that I made, the reason why I made 2 orders was because I was so excited to buy my Urban Decay stuff, but I wanted to wait until they released their electric palette, but I was too excited, so I made the order for everything else, and then the next day when the electric palette came out, I ordered the electric palette and one of their perversion, pick your perversion eyeliners. Anyways, so the first order, I'm trying to like get this out nicely. Maybe I should put it in front of me. Okay, so it came packaged so beautifully to me. It came in a little cardboard box. But when you opened it, there was so many layers of bubble wrap, tissue paper, purple tissue paper, Urban Decay printed tissue paper. It was just so nice, and it was miles better than when I first ordered from them years and years and years ago. They really stepped up their packaging. Okay, so I got, so this is the tissue paper it came with. It's really beautiful. And I won't swatch all the colors just because it'll be forever because I literally got so many things. So let me start off with the not just, okay. So I got the first thing. it's a Good Karma Optical Blurring Brush. So this is a foundation brush. It can be used with liquid or powder foundation. Obviously, I already used it. I have only used it once, and so far, I really love the results. It's really soft. It's vegan, cruelty-free. It's kind of heavy, so I probably wouldn't buy these brushes for my kit. Just because usually when I do people's makeup, you know, your hands get tired. I don't know. I just wouldn't use these brushes for my kit, but I would definitely like to buy more face brushes from Urban Decay just because I don't really like their eyeshadow brushes, just the ones that I've gotten in palettes, but I really like this foundation brush. And I would tell you guys the prices, but I, throughout the move and all that stuff, I left like all my receipts and stuff at my old house, so just basically anything you see online, 40% off of that. and I'll tell you guys which thing. I only got one thing that wasn't discounted with my pro discount. And I'll tell you guys about that when I show you. And then the next thing I got was the Big Fatty Mascara. I have heard a lot of, I don't know, I just heard a lot of people use this. And I was curious to try it for myself. And I honestly have never tried a cruelty-free mascara. So this is what the wand looks like. It's kind of similar to the Real, if it's gonna focus. The tip has little bristles. The formula is pretty thick. It kind of clumps a lot. I'm wearing it today. This is two layers. I don't know how much I like this. Maybe I have to wait for it to dry out a little bit. You guys know how sometimes mascaras have to dry out. And then I just got the Grindhouse pencil sharpener. And the reason why I got this was, number one, my pencil sharpener that I have is literally crap. I think it was probably the cheapest made pencil sharpener you will ever have. So I really needed a good sharpener. And I read that the Urban Decay pencils, they work better with the specific Urban Decay pencil sharpener just because it shaves off just the right amount so that you get the most use out of your pencils from Urban Decay. So, you know, Urban Decay, I mean, even though I do get a discount on it, I want to make it last as long as possible. So I got the little sharpener, and so far I really like it. I only have used the smaller hole. I don't have any jumbled pencils that I have sharpened yet, but yeah. And then I got, they just sent me a book of primers. Like, this is the exact book that you get with the Naked 3 palette, so now I have like a whole collection of these things. I won't need to buy primer ever again. Okay, now to the fun stuff. Okay, so first I'll show you my pencils. And you guys know, if you watched my most recent favorites video, I tried an Urban Decay pencil that my friend Jessica gave me and fell in love, so I knew that I had to buy every pencil ever from Urban Decay. Anyways, so I got this color Electric, and it's actually what I have underneath this eyeshadow. I'll show you guys eyeshadow that I'm wearing. But I'm actually wearing this underneath my eyeshadow today. And these are just so creamy, so pigmented. I honestly, all the hype you hear about these pencils is honestly true. I, like, will never go back to freaking, like, you know, the cheapest. Because honestly, how I used to buy my eyeliner was whatever was the cheapest at the drugstore. That's honestly how I used to buy my eyeliner. Not anymore. So I got Electric. I got the shade Junkie. Oh my gosh. Let me see if I can, this color, makeup on my hands, people. Oh my God. Honestly, I'm gonna have to post pictures of these swatches on Instagram. So make sure you follow me on Instagram. I'll link my information down below. But yeah, I got the shade Junkie. It's like a green with like a green kind of teal with gold glitter. Oh my gosh, so beautiful. Then I got the shade Ether. It's like a blackened, oh my God, it's like a blackened purple with like silver glitter. Seriously, people, I'm just gonna have to swatch all these on my Instagram because right now my lighting isn't doing justice. And then I got LSD. This is my favorite one. First of all, for the name. Just kidding. But the color is just, oh. People, this color, it's like blackened navy with blue glitter. Oh my god. People. And then I got the color Freak, which I thought would be really nice to make a Nicki Minaj like Bees in the Trap look. P.S. This makeup that I did today is inspired by Bees in the Trap. Inspired by, not exactly, but yeah. Yeah, so comment down below if you want this makeup tutorial or the green look from Bees in the Trap from Nicki Minaj. Okay, now I have so many eyeshadows. So my main colors that I wanted to get were blues, greens, and purples. I only got one green, but people, look at this name. Yes! Okay, if you guys don't get why I'm like breaking out over all these like drug-related names, is that I'm such a like straight-edge girl. If you guys know me, I never touch anything, not even alcohol, but I always like to joke around, like, oh my gosh, I like do all these drugs and stuff, but really, honestly, I will never do them. I don't know why I think it's so funny. I don't know, but yeah. So I got Kush, and it's just like the sparkly, bright green, which I think will also be good for that Bees in the Trap music video look. And people, I just want to say really quick about the new formulation of the Urban Decay shadows. They reformulated their eyeshadows, I think last year or the year before. And honestly, I thought their eyeshadows were already amazing, but once they went through that whole reformulating, oh my gosh, people, like, they are 10 times better, and I didn't think they could get any better. So honestly, Urban Decay eyeshadows are the best on the market. Seriously, people. Not even kidding. And now that they've gone through the reformulation, they're better than MAC, honestly, and they're cruelty-free, so, I win! Just kidding. Urban Decay wins. Anyways, okay, so that's the only green one I got, because the other greens that they had were kind of more dark, and I wanted, like, bright, fun colors. Okay, so now I'm going to show you guys my blues. So I got Height. I think that's how you pronounce it. Oh, it's just so beautiful. I'm going to have to swatch all these, too, on my Instagram. But, oh, so beautiful. And the next blue I got is called Peace, and it's actually what I'm wearing all over on my eyes today. Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. So beautiful. And another thing that inspired me was I've been watching a lot of Beat Face Honey makeup tutorials, and she uses a lot of Urban Decay shadows, and so that's another thing that inspired me to go crazy on Urban Decay. And then I got this other color called Evidence. It's like a dark navy. And then I got Radium, which, people, I have the eyeliner version, the 24/7 liquid liner of Radium, and I love that color. People, I'm sorry I'm going fast, but this video is going to be forever long. It's already 13 minutes. But like I said, just follow me on Instagram so you can see swatches. And then the purples, I got Asphyxia, which is this really light, lilac lavender color. It has a reflex of blue and pink. You can't really see it in this camera, but and then I got Omen, which is, again, really has different dimensions of blue and purple. Just when these colors hit the light, people, like, any given Urban Decay shadow, you will get different dimensions just from one shadow. Oh, and this one, Fishnet. I wanted to show you guys this one too, because I was looking at it online. I was like, you know what? That looks like a dupe for a MAC shadow called Stars and Rockets, which I actually have. And I bought it because I wanted a cruelty-free version. And I'll just show you guys side by side right now. This is Stars and Rockets right here. This is Stars and Rockets by MAC, and this is Fishnet. You can see they're pretty similar, but when I swatch them, I'll show you guys on my Instagram, it's a dupe. It's like an exact dupe, honestly. So if you guys really love the color Stars and Rockets from MAC, Fishnet from Urban Decay is a great, better alternative. And then the last single eyeshadow I got is called Flash, and it's the darkest purple I got. And it's kind of like a metallic-y, kind of silver reflex, like medium tone bright purple. It's good for if you want to do like a purple smoky eye. Now for my second order from Urban Decay. Oh, and just so you guys know, shout out to Z Palettes. I picked up some Z Palettes last year's Makeup Show LA, and this is just one that I had for my kit, and honestly had a second backup one just because I was like, hey, I never know when I might need an empty Z palette, and now I get to fill up. I love depotting, honestly, people. I love depotting, so I'm so excited to depot my single shadows and my Z palette. I'll link down where you can buy Z palettes down below. So my last two things, I got my Ink for Eyes. It's a new eyeliner that they came out for the spring collection from Urban Decay. And it's like a really, it says waterproof precision eye pen. And it's like, it's actually what I'm wearing on my eyes today. People, this, even though this is a fine tipped felt pen eyeliner, honestly, it's pretty easy to work with if you just kind of, I mean, I know liquid eyeliner, cat eyeliner is a pain, trust me, I've been there, I even struggled a little bit today, but this pen is actually pretty easy to use, and I mean, this is the first time I'm wearing it, so I can't say too much about like how waterproof or anything like that it is, but I honestly like it, and I like the like kind of like gunmetal bullet kind of packaging. And you guys, the thing that I'm most excited for, dun-dun-dun, the electric palette. And honestly, people, this has to be my favorite palette ever. I haven't even used it yet, but just the colors, like, this is my kind of palette. Everyone goes crazy about all those Naked palettes. Everyone goes crazy about every single neutral palette that comes out. And most of the time, to me, I don't even, like, care, because honestly a lot of neutrals look the same to me, but this, people, like, this is so me. Oh my god, I'm so excited. And these are actually pressed pigments, so you can actually use them, mix them with different things to create different types of makeup. So you can like take a little bit off, mix it on a little palette or like a little plate, you know, if you don't have a mixing palette. Mix it with some clear anything. Clear nail polish, you can make a nail polish. Clear lip gloss, you can make a colorful lip gloss. You can mix it with, some companies sell, like, mixing mediums, which, you can make, like, eyeliners. These are amazing. Like, honestly. Okay, so, this is another, these two colors right here, I think will be perfect for that Nicki Minaj Bees in the Trap music video. But anyways, oh my gosh, people. And it comes with a double-sided eyeshadow brush, which has purple bristles. Like, are you serious? This is so cute. And you get, it's like you get two brushes in one, which I really love. And you get this huge mirror, and the packaging is just, people, amazing. You don't even know how excited I am for this palette. Oh my god, this video is like 20 minutes long. I'm so sorry. That was a huge Urban Decay haul. I'm sorry it wasn't better quality. But if you guys have any questions, any requests for makeup tutorials, please let me know down below. And like I said, make sure to follow me or check out my Instagram. I'll link it down below so you guys can see swatches of everything. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you to all my new subscribers. I thank you all for being here. And I hope you guys have a good day. Peace, bunnies.